he was interested in social hypocrisy. He often said to the audience, there's the way you think your parents are, man, and then there's the way they are. That disparity interested him. And why a lot of us couldn't accept it. And he was interested in drugs, and he was interested in women, he was interested in jazz. He loved Gigi Grice. His favorite comedians were Buddy Hackett and Jonathan Winters. And he very much admired the social figure of the hipster. And he says, oh, come on, man, you know. And in that, his opposition to sham, that's why the musicians like him. Because musicians hate sham. What do I mean? An example is when I was around Kenton, the guys were very aware of drug enforcement entrapment. The guy would walk in and act like a musician, and he'd be, you know, he'd bust them. So they used to tell a story about a guy that comes in and he says, can I sit in with you guys? He takes his horn out and he's terrible. And one of the guys says to him, man, I sure hope you're a cop. That was very much Lenny Bruce's attitude. It was a social attitude. He had no political attitude. He thought it was a waste of time. He told me so. And he said, I'm surprised that such a guy as you would think there's a difference between Stevenson and Eisenhower. That's a direct quote. He thought the FBI was a racket. That J. Edgar Hoover, if he wasn't chasing guys that are subversive, he wouldn't get a check. It was kind of naive. It was not profound. And it wasn't meant to be.